Welcome back to Pastry Maestra. I'm Teresa and today I'm making milk chocolate panna cotta. Panna cotta, meaning cooked cream when translated from Italian, is one of the Italian classics and a small miracle. It can have countless flavors. It can be high or low in calories. It can be served on a plate or in a cup. Shortly, you can do whatever you want with it. Its origin isn't precisely determined, however, it is believed that panna cotta appeared in Lange, a hilly part of the Piemonte, which is a region in northern Italy, at the beginning of the 20th century. Basic panna cotta ingredients are cream, sugar, and gelatin. You can use double cream if you are not afraid of the fat content. But if you are concerned with the calories, use single cream, or you can even swap half of the cream with Greek yogurt. The mark of a perfectly executed panna cotta is its stability. If it wobbles like a little girl on high-heeled shoes, you can be certain that the mixture contains too much gelatin. The palate sensation is rubbery and sticky. The main challenge is to reduce the quantity of thickener as much as possible without losing consistency and creaminess. In my experience, for every 500 grams of liquid, you should use 7 grams of gelatin and the result will be perfect every time. Finally, let me point out a couple of reasons why panna cotta is a miracle dessert. First, it can be made in less than 5 minutes. Second, the quantity of sugar used is entirely up to you. You can make low sugar or even no sugar panna cotta, meaning you can use honey, agave syrup, maple syrup and other alternative sweeteners as you like. Not only that, panna cotta is always gluten-free and it can also be dairy-free. Thanks to gelatin, you can use almond milk, coconut milk and other non-dairy milks. And finally, you can make vegan panna cotta by replacing gelatin with agar-agar, carrageenan or unflavored vegan gel. I got tired from all this talking, so I'm going to recharge my batteries with some sweet, high-fat chocolate panna cotta. I hope you'll join me. As usual, the recipe is on my site. The link is down below. I'm gonna soak gelatin in cold water for a couple of minutes. As soon as my gelatin softens, I'm gonna take it out and squeeze to get rid of the excess water. I've put cream into a measuring cup and now I'm gonna add sugar and vanilla powder. I will stir the mixture and heat it in the microwave until sugar dissolves. The mixture doesn't have to boil, but it should be hot. My mixture is hot but not boiling. I'll add soaked and drained gelatin and stir until it melts. I've melted my milk chocolate in the microwave on low heat and now I'm gonna add cream and gelatin mixture to the melted chocolate little by little. I'll stir to combine after each addition until I end up with smooth uniform mixture. Now I will pour it into my glasses. That's it, I'm gonna pop them in the fridge for a couple of hours until set and chilled. While my chocolate panna cotta is chilling in the fridge, I'm gonna make chocolate crumble. I'm gonna put my sifted almond flour, powdered sugar, flour, cocoa powder and cold butter cut in dices into a food processor. Now I'm gonna pulse this mixture until it becomes crumbly. I will spread my crumble onto paper-lined baking pan and bake at 180 degrees centigrade, which is 350 Fahrenheit, for about 5 minutes. Then I'm gonna take it out of the oven and leave it to cool down. My chocolate panna cotta is set. I'll sprinkle some crumble on top and dig in. Mmm, yummy!
Delicious and yummy, so good to eat. I wanna lick you, feel your sweetness on my lips. Forever and ever, you'll stay on my hips.
I'm Teresa. Thanks for watching my video. I hope you liked it. If you wanna stay in touch, follow me on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. And of course, visit my site, where you can find elaborate posts with lots of pictures, additional information and recipes that follow my every video. Also, on my site you can download my free 365 pages ebook The Pastry Chef and maybe buy me a macaron, if you think that I've earned it. Now, before you go, please hit the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. That really helps a lot. Finally, and this is the most important thing, don't forget to create sweetness every day, because sweetness is happiness. See you in my next video. Bye!